Hey everyone, I'd like to introduce you to my next armour project. What I'm going to be making is a historically plausible and historically inspired suit of female fantasy armour. I'm just tagging on fantasy because I don't want to get restricted on trying to make a suit of armour that's pinned to being historically accurate. I want this to be a fun project, and I don't want to shackle myself with trying to adhere 100% to historical accuracy. I just want to have some fun with this, and ooh, it's a fun one. So, I don't want to go pure fantasy. A lot of those pure fantasy female armors you see out there, I find them very cringy. Some are nice. I do quite like the Arm Street ones, which are fantasy. They're not cringy, but some are. Let's be honest, we've all seen cringy, horrible fantasy armor out there, and yeah, I don't want to go in that direction. And you know, my partner originally requested boob armor, and I'm like, I don't really want to do boob armor. But what I can do is I can take real pieces of armour and tweak them slightly to give them a more feminine aesthetic and to give the armour a more feminine silhouette. So, yeah, not gonna make boob armour, though I will have be giving it quite a feminine silhouette, which most of this is going to be based on 14th century. Early 14th century armors, so you know, that's not going to be too hard to create a feminine silhouette out of that, because we've got, you know, large chest plates, narrow waists, and lots of skirts of plate, so making something that looks feminine shouldn't be too hard. So my plan for this is to take historical and historically accurate armor designs and just tweak the curvatures and tweak the proportions of them to give a more feminine outline and feminine aesthetic, so that even though it will be a fantasy armor, it won't look that out of place in amongst other early 14th century armors. In fact, I could probably tweak it all back and produce one for myself with more masculine proportions, and I'd blend right in, and my hope is to make this look feminine, but also not stand out in amongst historically accurate armors too much. I know us massive armor nerds can spot historical inaccuracies to the point where it's borderline an obsession and it ruins basically every movie. I can't watch Monty Python and the Holy Grail without picking out the accuracy of the armor. I can't turn that part of my brain off, I'm sorry. And I'm going to be saving all of the templates for this and making them available. So if anybody else wants to have a go at recreating this suit of armor, you can. Now, some of you who follow me on Instagram will maybe have seen me doing some concept art for this suit of armor. What we're planning on doing is starting with a Cherberg 13 breastplate, and instead of having the relatively square midsection, here is a Cherberg 13 breastplate, instead of having that quite square rectangular middle section, what I'm planning on doing is giving it more of a making it a bit wider around here, so it comes up and out, and using the edges and the lines to create more of a feminine silhouette, or a, you know, basically use lines to enhance the narrowness of the waist. And yes, this is because it's a Cherberg Type 13 with all of the extra lines, I can use them, and it's in some of the cardboard templates I've been working on so far. It's starting to be somewhat suggestive of a corset, while definitely looking like armour. So, looks like armour, but the lines are very feminine, enhancing the narrowness of the waist and exaggerating the bust, as requested. This gives more. We're enhancing the hourglass shape, which, before anybody, that was also done in male armor, because in the fashion of the time, narrow waists and large chests and a skirt was part of male fashion at the time. So armor enhanced that physique. That's the look they were going for, and we're creating a very feminine outline, and, you know, we're just enhancing a little bit more, and, you know, it looks very pretty, and my partner absolutely loves it, and her opinion is the one that really matters. So, yeah, we're using a Cherberg Type 13 for the upper body defense. However, my partner did request a backplate, and, yes, the Cherberg 13 does not have backplate. So I'm thinking of doing a hinged and strapped closing backplate, such as on the back of it's a St. George figure from Madrid in the National Museum of Nuremberg, having hinged up the back. But also, we're planning on doing a scale fold, or punts of plates. Punts? Points? I don't know, I'm Australian, so eh. It's skirt of plates. A scale skirt is what we're going for the lower torso defense. Originally, we were thinking of doing a banded, hooped construction fold. However, because it's a Cherberg Type 13, which is an articulated and flexible breastplate, having a flexible breastplate and then a rigid lower half, it just didn't look right. And we had that in the original concept art for this build, but we've gone back and redesigned it, especially after showing my partner this depiction of St. George. She really liked the look of the scales, and there's some other good depictions of it's a detail from the introduction page of the Tree of Battles of Honor Bonnet, which is French, circa 1400, which is in the Armour of the English Knight, 1400 to 1450, by Dr. Tobias Catwell. If we look in this page here, we can see several examples of skirts of what appear to be scales. And, you know what, we have an articulated top, scales to articulate the bottom, we've done cardboard mock-ups, it looks really good. And, yeah, so we're using, it looks really good. But yeah, the legs are going to be, you know, just typical 14th century leg harness. The shoulders we're going with, we want to give this armor relatively small spaulders, because we don't want large pauldrons giving large masculine shoulders to the physique, because, you know, my partner does not want to look huge and masculine in this armor. She wants to look feminine in this armor. So by having small shoulders, as opposed to big, broad, space marine shoulders, it's going to, you know, avoid that huge masculine aesthetic, such as, you know, of course, Italian armors with their huge pauldrons, which I like the look of, but I like it because it makes a more masculine physique, but she wants a more feminine physique. So we're going to have relatively small shoulders. We'll probably be imitating an English style. There's some very good, let's see if I can find one. There's some very good drawings in this book. That's kind of what we're going with, because it does not add too much width across the shoulders. Doesn't give you huge broad shoulders, and it's quite nice. And I would like to build one of those. However, with the besigues, which are these round, or that one's square, with the besigues, what we're doing, long ago, I made this as a gift for my soon-to-be wife, and it's a hand-forged steel rose. So instead of doing, you know, just a round besicue to protect the armpit, I was thinking of doing some large steel roses, and I think that would look very nice. But also, if we're just talking practically, that shape on besicue would be, I reckon, it'd be pretty efficient. If anyone tries to aim a lance or a sword thrust at your armpit, and it clips one of them, it's just going to feed it straight into the middle, trap the tip of their blade, possibly damage it, or it stop us. Yeah, lance going into that would catch it. Though, I'm not sure. Some of the guys who fight in armor and are more knowledgeable, would it be better for a besigue to catch a lance or deflect it away? I'm not really sure. Leave a comment below. So yeah. Normal arms, normal legs, a scaled skirt section, articulated upper body. We've not settled on a helmet yet, and of course for there upwards, because, you know, Cherberg only comes up so high, and you've got a section for the gorget or coif. I'm tempted to try and convince her to go with a scale coif, purely because I hate knitting mail, and I think a scale one would look gorgeous. And of course, I said this was going to be fantasy, and that's probably going to be the bit that's the most fantasy about it, unless you know of an example of a scale coif. Please, let me know in the comments below. So, yeah, we'll be saving and making all of the templates available eventually, and I hope you'll come along for this project and enjoy. Now, if you're interested in the historical accuracy of female armor, there is a good lecture I would point you towards that's available on YouTube. If you look up Ladies in Plating, it's a lovely talk given on depictions of women in armour in medieval art. Though some of these depictions are technically, well, not technically, they are fantasy armours in medieval art, which was a thing, both for men and women, which can make some things with trying to work out, was this suit of armour real, or is this just fancy, a little bit tricky, in sometimes with medieval art. And, yeah. yeah, so, if you're... Before anyone tries to... Well, actually, me, about the subject of women in armour, go watch that. Now, a lot of people will say, just make it the same as a man. Well, if I will point you towards watching that lecture, because four surviving examples of armour that belonged to historical women, I am not aware of any of them having significant differences between them and armour of the time period for a man. Even that... even that lecture shows a few examples that are attributed to famous women, which it can be hard to nail down who the exact owner of a particular suit of armour was, so give it with a grain of salt. However, within historical, there are literary sources historically which suggest that maybe female armour at some times was a little bit different to male armour, and however, if we look at surviving examples in artwork, a lot of times what we see is women wearing the same kind of armour as the men. However, we also sometimes see women wearing armour that is significantly different to the men. However, this can sometimes be because what's being depicted is fantasy, or it's meant to be history, so they put them in an Atlantique armour, which is in itself a form of fantasy armour within the medieval art genre. I'm getting a little bit too in-depth into the history of medieval art and depictions of women in medieval art, aren't I? Yes, that's probably... Yeah, that's a tangent for another time. Honestly, I think her arm was going to look better at the medieval festival than mine is.